Hello everyone and welcome back to the channel. In today's video I'll show you how to fix the issue where your Windows 11 PC gets stuck on the spinning circle during restart or shutdown. This problem can be really frustrating, but by following these simple steps you should be able to get your system running back to normal. So without wasting any more time, let's jump right in. First, try to boot into the Windows built-in troubleshoot utility. To do this, perform a hard power off 3 times in a row. This will force Windows to automatically launch the advanced startup option. If it does, you will be taken to a screen where you can choose advanced options to begin troubleshooting. Now, if the troubleshoot utility doesn't appear, you can download a Windows 10 or 11 media creation utility, create an ISO file to burn it into a USB or a DVD, then boot your PC from that media. So you can also refer to the manufacturer's instructions, which usually involve pressing a key like Escape, F2, F8, or F12 during startup to access the recovery options. Once you're in the recovery environment, select Repair Your Computer at the bottom left of the dialog box. Then choose Troubleshoot. Now from the Troubleshoot option, navigate to the Advanced Options. Over here, you will have multiple choices. You can attempt a system restore by clicking on this option. If you click on this, you will have a restore point saved on your computer. Then all you have to do is simply pick the restore point and then click on next to restore your computer to a particular point in time. That is the first option that you can try. You can also reset your PC while keeping your personal files. So for doing that, all you do is just simply go back to this menu. And over here, you'll have reset this PC. If you click on this option, you will have the option of keep my files and remove everything. Now to keep every file that you have and do a complete factory reset, you have to choose the first option. And then once you choose that option over here, you will have options called cloud download or local reinstall. So what you have to do is choose local reinstall. It'll reinstall Windows directly from your device without harming any of your internal files. It'll take some time to complete, but once it is done, you should be able to log back in. Next, you can try to uninstall your recent updates. So for doing that, just click on uninstall updates right over here. Then you will have two options, uninstall latest quality updates and uninstall latest feature updates. The latest quality updates are small updates that happen usually within 1 to 2 days. The latest feature updates are those that happen once every 2 to 3 months, which are the big updates. So if you're facing a problem after a certain update, try to uninstall the update depending on whatever update you had last. Next, you can simply try to click on Startup Repair to see if it is able to reboot you into the computer, and if that doesn't work, you can always boot into safe mode as well. So for doing that, all you have to do is just simply click on Startup Settings right over here. Then just click on the Restart option right over here, and that will boot you into safe mode. So just click on the Restart option and wait for a few seconds. Now over here, you will have a few options, so you have to choose any one of them. Like for example, on my system, you have to choose Enable Safe Mode. So just press 4 on your keyboard and that should be able to launch you into safe mode on your computer. So it'll take some time to be patient and wait for it to complete. Now assembly, enter the PIN, and now you'll be able to launch yourself into a safe mode and try to fix any problem that might be there. And after fixing the problem or uninstalling the latest updates, if you're still facing the issue, just simply restart the computer and come back to the troubleshooting option. So after using all the methods, if you're still facing the issue, try using the command prompt for further repair. So what you have to do is after you booted back into the add-on option, select command prompt. So once you're on the command prompt, first just type C, then colon. Now at end, once I've done that, just simply type DIR and then hit enter. Now the moment you'll do that, you will be able to see all the program files, users, and Windows, and old Windows. So if this appears, that means you're in the correct drive, but in some cases your directory might not be in C and it might be in G or F. So you have to find the proper direct code as you can see right over here. Now next what you would do is just simply type CD /System32. Then again, backward slash, then config, and now just going to hit enter. Now, once you're in the config space, what you have to do is just type copy, then the space, then the asterisk symbol, now the peer symbol or dot, whatever you may call. Then again, asterisk, then space, and backup. Now, just simply hit enter. Now, once the backup process is complete, just simply type cd space reg back, then just simply hit enter. And now that should bring you to the config, the reg back folder. So once you're over here, just type dir, then hit enter. Now, once this opens, type copy space asterisk dot asterisk space double dot. As you can see, this is the command, then hit enter. Then after that, you should have the option of override. Then simply hit Y on your keyboard, and then at that point, just simply close the command prompt, and you should be able to see the continue option. Simply click on that, and you should be able to log back into your Windows, so wait for a few seconds. Now just simply enter the PIN, and it should be able to get back into your Windows without any issue. So that's it. By following these troubleshoot steps from booting into your recovery environment to running system repair commands, you should be able to fix the spinning circle issue during restart or shutdown on Windows 11. So if this video helped you, please give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and subscribe to the channel for more helpful videos. So thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.